Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see how we can adjust oscillator frequency of TL494. TL494 is SMPS controller. It can work in push-pull drive, that it can drive two MOSFETs, that is called push-pull drive, or it can work as a single-ended operation. At that time, it will drive both transistors at the same time. So when we are using in push-pull, oscillator frequency here will be divided by 2 at output stage. It is a question from my viewer: what value of RTCT can I use to get 100 Hz push-pull 50-50 Hz using TL494? He need 50 Hz here, 50 Hz here, so we need 100 Hz here. There is RTCT and frequency chart. Using this chart, we can select the capacitor, resistor and frequency. If I need 100 Hz, I can use 1 microfarad capacitor, or I can use 0.1 microfarad capacitor, or I can use 0.01 10 nanofarad capacitor. For that purpose, we need to select resistors. So here is a guideline. Practical value of RTCT can be used 1 kilo ohm to 500 kilo ohms. So if we will use small capacitor, at that time the resistor value will very high. For that purpose, we need to remain within limit. 470 pico to 10 microfarad capacitor can be used. First, we need to select capacitor. The available size of the capacitor, for example, if I will use 1 microfarad capacitor, the resistor value around 10 to 11, 12 kilo ohms. If I will use some lower value capacitor, the resistor value will increase. When we will reduce the capacitor size, the resistor value will increase. There is a formula. If we want to use single-ended operation, what is single-ended? When pin number 13 of this IC is grounded, at that time it will work in single-ended operation. When pin number 13 is connected to reference pin number 14, pin number 13 and 14 are connected together, that means it is pulled up high. At that time, the frequency will divide it by 2. This formula we will use. Or we can use directly this formula, because we need 100 Hz. For a best practice, first we need to select the capacitor within the acceptable range. Test its value with some good capacitance meter. So practical capacitor value and its tolerance must be minimum. That will much better. It is 681 nanofarad. We will connect this capacitor between pin number 5 and ground. 1 divided by 100 Hz multiplied by 0.681 microfarad. 10 raised to power minus 6. The resistor value will be around 14,684 ohms. If we will use here 681 nanofarad capacitor, at that time the resistor value will 14.684 kilo ohm. But when we use practically, at that time there is some tolerance and there is frequency variation. So for that purpose, we can use a trim pot or variable resistor here. At pin number 6, we can connect 10 kilo ohm resistor, and we can add another variable resistor. We can use 10 kilo ohm. So we can adjust and we can compensate the variation. This will connect it to pin number 6, that is RT pin. Let's check it practically. If we will use the exact this value of the resistor, might be it will not give the calculated result at low frequency. If we are using at 40 kilohertz, 100 kilohertz, at that time the calculated frequency, calculated component value will approximately closer to our required value. But in this case, when we are using at low frequency or high frequency, the frequency variation will plus or minus. Here we are getting 50 hertz. Now first I will connect to CT pin. At timing capacitor, this is timing capacitor signal that is provided at CT pin. It is now exact 100 hertz. We can adjust using this trim pot. We can use this potentiometer trim pot. We can connect one end to the resistor in series with the resistor. The second end we can connect to ground. Here we can adjust our required frequency. So it is now 100 hertz. This 100 hertz will divide it into two channels, channel A, channel B. It is giving exact 50 hertz. And if we check the resistor value this time, it is 20.25 kilo ohms, while our calculated value is 14.6 kilo ohm, because when we are working at low frequency, at that time we need to consider the variation of the frequency using frequency chart. Let's select one microfarad capacitor. Yes, it is 1 microfarad. Before this, the capacitor value was 0.681 microfarad. It is exactly 1 microfarad. Now, when I will increase this capacitor size, now we can see the frequency has now dropped 33 hertz at each channel. We can adjust frequency from this potentiometer. And when we are using 1 microfarad capacitor, value of both resistors is 13.66 kilo ohms. And if we check here, our capacitor is 1 microfarad, the calculated resistance is 10 kilo ohms, but the practical, that is 13 kilo ohms. So in this way we can calculate the closer value, and we need to adjust our resistor value. When we adjusted the frequency using a trim pot and we found the exact value at that time, we can lock this adjustment screw using any thread locker or any adhesive, any epoxy, so that it will remain at fixed position. Otherwise its resistance may vary with the vibration, or we can measure the both resistor values as we measured from ground to this point. We can measure the resistor and we can select a fixed resistor to obtain the exact frequency. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.